And now, ladies and gentlemen, the next hot topic, recession or slowdown in India. We'll find out. I request our next speaker, CA Dr. Vinayak Govilkar from CA Govilkar and Associates, to please step forward for the next session.
Good afternoon, everybody. At the outset, let me thank the organizers for inviting me here and asking me to share my views on a very critical topic, very contemporary topic, a topic about which there is a lot of debate and discussion. And therefore, I have given the title to my presentation as Facts and Fear. Everybody knows for last almost 7-8 months, a lot of debate is on regarding this economic growth of India. I have put some of the figures just to know what happened in last 7-8 years. For the year 12-13, the rate of GDP growth was 5.46. We went up to 7.17, and then we started with 5.8 in the first quarter of 19-20, and in the second quarter, it has further came down to 5%. And everybody started worrying about this. Let me bring your attention to the rate of growth in 12-13. I have said recession or slowdown. What's the difference in the two? And technically, should we call the present situation in India as a recession? There are two factors which we will have to add to fall in demand. In both the cases, there is fall in demand, recession or slowdown. But the fall in demand in all sectors of the economy, one condition, all sectors of the economy, not only in few like automobile, textile, etc. And second condition is for a long period of time. So if there is fall in demand in all sectors of the economy for a long period of time, one can name it as recession. Otherwise, we should call it as slowdown. So for last two quarters, the GDP growth rate of India is slowing down. The period is two quarters. And we all know that all the sectors of the economy are not yet affected. To the extent, few industries are affected. The next question that we have to consider is it only India that is suffering from this slowdown? The answer obviously is no. As the earlier speaker, Dr. Lakshmi, has said, that this fall in demand is in almost all countries of the world. I will name first 5 countries in the world, starting with US, the number one. In the first quarter of 19, the growth rate was 3.2%, and in the second quarter, it has come down to only 2.1%. One can notice the rate of fall, the percentage of fall. Same is true for China. It has achieved the growth rate, which is less than the rate of growth rate for last 27 years, in spite of the stimulus package provided for previous almost 16 months. China is also facing slowing down demand, and they have started giving the stimulus package. I hope we know this stimulus package can be of two types. One is the monetary stimulus package and another one is fiscal stimulus package. One is related to supply of money and rate of interest, whereas the other one is related to reduction in the tax rates and incentives given, whereby the fisc of the government gets affected. The third country is Japan, which is also struggling to get out of this recession. Then is Germany. Their national income seeing a significant drop. In the second quarter of 19, their national income appears to have decreased by 0.1%. We are sixth in number so far as GDP is concerned. Singapore has cut down the growth rate from previously expected 1.5% to 2.5% and now estimates it at 0% to 1%. And probably the situation is not different in Brazil, Mexico, Hong Kong and Britain. My point is that it is not only India which is facing this fall in demand. What are the causes for this? Some are global causes, some are internal domestic causes. As we all know, it is US and China trade war. Till date, the US has applied exclusive tariffs to China worth $250 billion. And China has also reciprocated and they have levied duties to the tune of 110 billion. So this trade war imposing the duties on imports is affecting the world trade. Trade disputes between South Korea and Japan is the another reason. Long pending Brexit issue. We have seen two prime ministers have changed. Still, there is no conclusive steps taken for Brexit. The rising interest in the world, fluctuating crude oil prices, geopolitical instability, and the inflation are some of the reasons, causes for the global slowing down of economy. With this, we can conclude saying that slowdown is not only in India, but it is in many countries of the world. And second, many developments in the world are also contributing to the slowdown in India. After the globalization, particularly after the WTO agreements and liberalization policy adopted in India, well, the economies of different countries are interconnected, interrelated, interdependent. And naturally, therefore, anything happen in any country and particularly in developed countries, well, the effect is spread in many other countries too. What are the internal causes for this present situation? Number one is agriculture. As we know that in India, people dependent on agriculture, number wise, this number is very high. And there is no major improvement in last few years regarding four things. Number one is productivity of agriculture. Second is prices for the agriculture produce. System of sale of goods and irrigation facilities. Because of this, the purchasing power of the farmers, those who are dependent on agriculture in India, has not improved a lot. Some efforts have been made regarding increasing the productivity of the agriculture. Some improvements definitely have been made. Similarly, some improvements have been made regarding irrigation. But if we consider the two things, prices for agriculture produce and system of sale of goods agriculture produce, we find very negligible improvement in these two. So though the output has gone up, though we have become self-reliant, so far as food grains are concerned, still the sale of agriculture produce is a problem, and getting proper prices for agriculture produce is another problem. Manufacturing and core infrastructure industries growth is slowing down quite dramatically. After the agriculture, we come to the industry and we find infrastructure and manufacturing, there is a slowdown also. And because of this, the unemployment has been unusually high and growing. There is also one reason: foreign portfolio investment has been leaving the economy for various reasons. I think I'm just giving you the points here, time being the constraint. These are some of the internal causes. Low public investments. Probably everybody knows that since 2014, the government is giving more thrust, more importance to fiscal discipline. And therefore, the fiscal deficit, the revenue deficit figures have come down substantially. Revenue is not growing up. Deficit is to be kept under control. And because of that, spending on the part of the government is limited. Low private investment, maybe because of inconsistency in public policies, for example, car manufacturing, GST rates and whatnot, non-performing assets of the banking sector and NBFC crisis. Because of these two, credit available in the market and the simplicity, ease of getting the credit is affected. Consumer and investment sentiment also is changing in last couple of months. These are the causes for, internal causes for the present economic situation. Now, how to come out of this? There are four factors which give impetus to the economic development. The first is increase in private sector investment. Well, we expect everything, any problem in the economy, everybody expects that this is the job of the government to find out a solution for that. And that is true also. Whatever may be the ideology of the government, maybe a communist government, maybe a liberal government, well, ultimately, policy making is the job of the government. Whether government will do it on its own, or government will get it done from the private sector. But this policy is also to be decided by the government. Hence, government has to take some steps to increase the private investments. Investment may be in new projects or expansion of the existing projects. This is one part which may be a remedial action for the current economic situation. The second is increase in government investment. I have used the word government investment, not government spending. In 2008, because of that subprime crisis in US, well, US started facing economic problems. That got converted into slowdown, recession, and it spread in other countries too. To come out of that, well, US started using monetary measures. Probably all of you may be aware that these measures were called as quantitative